Find the slope of the line through the given points. Now, slope is a representation of rate of change. And what we're comparing here is x and y. So we can find the amount of change between the x's and the y's, and then we can compare it by dividing. So from 0 to 2, you're increasing by 2, so plus 2. From 2 to 4, also plus 2. Let's look at the y's. From 4 to 9, you're adding 5. And then from 9 to 14, you're adding 5. So the slope is change in y divided by the change in x. Okay, so the change in y we said was 5, and the change in x was 2. So that means our slope is 5 halves, or you can write it as 2.5 or 2 and 1 half. I'll circle this one here, but all three are the same answer, really. So why do I have a graph here if all you have to do is look for the pattern in the table? Well, I want to show you some other ways to look at slope also. Let me go ahead and plot these points. So 0, 4, that's the first coordinate. So 0 for x and then up 4 for y. And the next one is 2 and then up 9, 3, 6, let me try that again, 3, 6, 9, right there. And the next one is 4 and then 14, 10, 11, 12, 13, that would actually be about up here. Okay, now these points actually form a line, and you can see that you could draw a line through here. But let's look at the change here. We're going up 5 and then right 2. Up another 5, right 2 more. So the slope represents the steepness of the line that would go through these three points. Like that. And there's another way to do these, is you can also use what's called the slope formula, and you can subtract y and subtract x. So for example, it would be 9 minus 4 divided by 2 minus 0 if you use the first two points from the table. So 9 minus 4 is 5, and then 2 minus 0 is 2. So you can see you get 5 halves this way also, same way as the first time. Okay, so I've shown you how to look at slope from a repeated pattern on a table, how to look at it in a graph, and how to use the slope formula by subtracting the y's and the x's. And I hope that clears things up for you a little bit.